like a colorful background.
We're just really, you know, blue, yellow, sunshine era, I guess.
It actually feels very appropriate for us because Sabrina has chosen to release this album at the end of August. But for us, that means we're going into summer.
Yeah, it's practically summer now.
It's practically summer in Australia.
We have like 2 months of winter.
We just arrived in summer.
Hi!
Guys, hi!
Oh my god! It feels like we haven't filmed for you in a hot minute.
No, the last few videos that you guys have seen here were pre-filmed before we went over to Europe.
We're back!
It was a lot of fun, but we're very, very happy to be home. And we're very, very happy to finally be reacting to this album today. So while we were gone, Sabrina Carpenter, little girly, she released Short and Sweet.
She sure did. What a perfect album title for her. She is truly short and sweet. Having met her, we can confirm this. She is the sweetest, cutest, smallest little pocket of sunshine.
Yeah, she's great.
You know, I really feel like she's found her niche in pop music. Like, I think there's so many reasons why her success has really peaked at the moment. I think she's found her look, she's found her sound. She has found like this niche, like pop, girly, glamour, humor.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah, her lyrics are just really funny. Like she's not super serious, which I think really works for her and is really quite different to what a lot of the other pop girlies are doing.
Totally.
And on that note too, I do think as well that like her timing of releasing this new album is absolutely perfect. Mm-hmm. I mean, we all know that this year has been for the girls. I'm sorry, is there a man inside on the charts?
Like, no. I'm actually a little bit concerned.
Yeah, it's only the girls. And, you know, coming off the back of opening for the Eras tour and everything as well, I just think it's just, she's done this perfectly. Whoever's decision it was, whether it was her or her team, I don't know.
She's just killed it.
But she is doing something.
I'm so happy for her. Yeah, it's really great. She really does. I'm so excited.
It's nice to see her finally have her real moment. This album has gone number one. We know that obviously Jack Antonoff is involved with this album, which is so a lot. And we actually saw Jack live in Germany last week.
Oh my god, stop. We saw him with our eyeballs. So illegal. That was really too much.
We saw bleachers with our eyeballs.
He was phenomenal.
Jumping back to the album title, I mentioned to you a week ago that some people are saying that they think maybe it's called Short and Sweet because the album is about like short and sweet relationships.
Totally, yeah.
And that kind of leads me into the fact that I've seen some rumors online that people think some of these songs are about a relationship that she had with Shawn Mendes, which mm-hmm. is interesting. I didn't know that had happened until people started talking about it. Mm. But you're also kind of in your Shawn Mendes era because she started listening to Shawn's new singles and she's like, what the fuck? He's in his folklore
era.
I'm into it.
So today we're going to react to the whole album here on YouTube. Mm-hmm. There is two bonus tracks and we're going to react to those over on our Patreon. So check that out if you want to. Our Patreon community is the reason we can make these videos. So thank you guys so much for supporting us on there. We don't make anything from these YouTube videos, so that is what makes all of these videos possible.
Yeah.
And we love you guys. We're so grateful.
We do.
We've got 10 songs to listen to today because we've already heard two.
Yes, absolutely.
Let's get into it.
I am so excited. No, I genuinely... Do you know what? I feel like I haven't been this excited to listen to a new album this year since we reacted to Chapel Roan. Some of these melodies are going to be absolutely offensive.
I already know I'm going to love this album.
Yeah.
Which is like, I'm like biased, but I just know. Yeah. I actually can't. Taste is the first song.
Oh!
That's the single.
This is the single. Yes.
Oh, yes. And we're also going to react to this music video on Patreon.
Yes,
as well.
We are.
Oh, yeah. I'm excited.
Now, can I just say that actually, I saw somebody tweet the other day and they said that they think that the run of singles that she's released from this album, so Espresso, Please, 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 and Taste, they said that they reckon it's going to go down in history as being just as iconic as Shake It Off, Blank Space, and Style. And I thought that was really interesting because obviously Espresso and Please, Please, Please have been such incredibly huge singles.
Yeah.
But it was interesting that they put Taste into this because I have no idea what this song tastes like. Oh,
Tastes like.
Sounds like. But I thought that was a really interesting take because those two songs have been really big this year.
Yeah, it's a big one to compare. I think only time can really tell those kind of things. But I have high hopes.
Yes.
And faith in Miss Sabrina Carpenter.
Absolutely.
Oh, I leave quite an impression. 5 feet to be exact.
what did she do that? Puffy, whatever that fucking melody was so offensive already.
The feet, the 5 feet.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was offensive.
I'm sorry,
it's a guitar. It's like a grungy guitar.
Can we actually start this again? Because I feel like immediately went into lyrics and I like wasn't even ready for it.
Oh, I leave quite an impression. 5 feet to be exact. You're wondering why half his clothes went missing. My body's where they're at. Now I'm gone, but you're still laying next to me. 1 degree of separation.
Why is she so smart and sassy and clever and witty?
This is already like fitting into that what you just said about her lyrics being really humorous. Like, yes. She's got this funny little thing going on. What did she just say?
She's like, you'll taste me when you're kissing him.
Yeah, some shit like that. No, the melodies of this are really fucked up. I'm actually really concerned.
I feel like there's either two reasons you might feel that about someone. Like that kind of feeling like, you'll taste me when you kiss him. Either like you've been with that person for so long or it's been very recent. Like he's moved on so quickly.
Oh, I leave quite an impression. 5 feet to be exact. That 5 feet. No. I'm actually really serious about how concerning these melodies are.
No, I agree. Yeah.
This sounds like something, like it feels nostalgic, like it's got this, like, I don't know, like an early 2000s kind of feel to it or something. I can't believe the melody. The melody is what's gotten me. Now I'm gone, but you're still laying next to me, 1 degree of separation, because like the guy is like their 1 degree of separation, like her and the new girl, I'm guessing.
Oh,
she said, I heard you're back together. And if that's true, you'll just have to taste me when he's kissing you. Oh. So they've been in a relationship. She was the rebound and then they got back together. And she's like, I had your man while you were on a break.
That this or is some what shit. People might be drawing with Sean and Camilla. Because remember when they got back together and so that Sabrina had been in the middle there.
That is some piping hot tea. Yeah, oh my God. If you want forever, and I bet you do, just know you'll taste me too. No.
Oh my God.
No!
That guitar!
It's like this summery electric guitar.
It pins you down on the carpet, makes paintings with his tongue.
This is everything I want in a sound, in a song. You know how we feel about a summery guitar. This is deeply superior and iconic. This is going up on the wall of summer iconic albums like Solar Power, like 1989. I mean, we predicted.
Oh, we did. They're like literally the albums that we just put behind us.
Immaculate.
Every time you close your eyes and feel his lips, you're feeling mine. And every time you breathe his air, just know I was already there. You can love him if you like. I've been there, done that once or twice. And singing about it don't mean I care. Yeah, I know I've been known to share.
I've been known to share? Oh my God. I can't believe she just said that. Oh my God.
Sabrina. I'm so sorry, but she literally gives no fucks.
She gives no fucks.
And then the laugh. No fucks.
Wait, yeah, I actually need to hear that again. That was so funny.
If you like, I've been there, done that once or twice, and sing about it.
no.
Wait, that whole kind of bridge was referencing... I mean, we all know what she's referencing. We don't need to say it. Because she says, like, I've been there once or twice. Like, she's kind of done that before as well. Like, gone back to someone who's had someone else. And singing about it don't mean I care. I love that as well, because that's also, I feel like, referencing past situations. Like, just because she's singing about it or, like, addressing it publicly doesn't mean she still cares. Mm-hmm. It's just, like, part of her experience, part of her story. Mm-hmm. So she's kind of like... Oh, I love that. I love that.
Absolutely. You know, I also think as well that, like, it's really clever for her to put a lyric like that in here, because I think that, like, what we've seen with somebody like Taylor Swift writing so autobiographically throughout her career is that she creates this, like, this lore that, you know, like, now we as all Taylor Swift fans, we hear a new song and we know she's referencing something that she said, like, five albums ago, you know? Yeah. And it's so important to develop that connection between fans and your music. Mm. And I think the fact that she literally had Because I Liked a Boy on the last album, and now she's got this lyric on this album. Like, it's great. Like, I think that for people who don't already know the story or whatever, she's kind of giving us that information just in her lyrics, like, which is the same thing. Like, she's building that lore around her own image and her own life. Mm-hmm. And she's learned from the best.
Is a fight back to slut shaming in its own as well. And I think that that's also something that girls can do now with a lot more confidence because of the world that we live in, as opposed to someone like Taylor, who like, it took so much more time for people to stop that narrative.
That's true.
Like, you know, she's done this before, or she's, of course, she's in this situation.
Yeah.
And I like that Sabrina's like owning that, laughing about that.
Yeah.
Because it kind of takes the power away from other people that are using it against her.
Absolutely. And ultimately, she never did anything wrong.
No,
so she's like, why should I feel bad about this? I'm gonna sing about it because I didn't do anything.
No. Well, I heard you're back together. I love that guitar. That's true. You'll just have to tease me when he's kissing you.
Good help.
She's really just like my give a fucks are on vacation. Like, even though she's singing about this kind of topic that you could be taking as like a heartbreak topic, she is in her power. It's a very positive, upbeat song, even though she's singing about something that might be hurtful.
Absolutely.
I love that spin on that, and like the humor and the lightness, and just like the vibes are immaculate.
Absolutely. Vibes are immaculate. That was superior. I loved it so much.
Okay, so the second track is Please, Please, Please.
Oh, yeah,
which obviously
cool.
We've heard.
Yes.
And now we're on to Good Graces.
Okay. This has also got like an early 2000s energy to it.
When I love you.
Oh my god.
Like an angel. John. No, I'm so sorry. Why is everything, not everything, but I feel like I'm hearing songs lately that keep reminding me of Center Stage.
Oh!
The soundtrack of Center Stage.
Yeah, yeah.
Guys, my dance girlies. No. There's a song on Center Stage that sounds like this boom, boom. And we're dancing, and it feels so romantic. Oh my god, this is so pretty.
Don't mistake my nose for naive. I don't waste a second. I know
lots of guys. You do something suspect. This cute. Oh my god, I can't even focus on what she's saying because there's so much happening in the production. That's
there's so many little noises.
Little noises,
I'm so sorry, but that guitar right at the beginning, that bing, ding, 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 it's
beautiful.
Just, it's so. I mean, it reminds me of superior times.
Yeah.
Early 2000s in the summertime.
It's definitely giving an early 2000s. This is her sound. This is my favorite sound of hers. 100%.
Yeah.
Like, I'm absolutely obsessed. As cute as bye-bye. Like, ooh, baby, you say you really like it being mine. So let me give you some advice. Boy, it's not that complicated. You should stay in my good graces. Turning love and the hatred.
The heterosexual girlies are just like, can you please just figure it the fuck out? Because it's not that fucking hard.
It's not that hard.
To keep me fucking happy.
No, it's really
like
hard.
You make out girls to be like these crazy emotional, like can't figure you out at all. It's actually really not hard.
It's really not
it's
that
not
hard.
That complicated.
No, and she's like, stay in my good graces.
If you love me right, like you actually don't even understand. Like yeah. I will give you so much love.
Totally.
But do not fuck me over.
Yeah.
Because I'm not just gonna stay
yeah.
and deal with you being an ass. The pre-chorus, she said, I don't waste a second. I know lots of guys. You do something suspect. This cute ass, bye-bye.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, baby, you say you really like it being mine, so let me give you some advice.
Yes. Oh, that's when she was, like, speaking it, was it? Is that the pre-chorus?
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
I loved that. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Boy, it's not that complicated. You should stay in my good graces mm-hmm. or I'll switch it up like that so fast because no one's more amazing at turning loving into hatred. Slay.
She's really good at keeping her songs like very interesting.
Completely agree.
Just the tone of her voice or how she presents like a sentence can be really interesting because she has so much attitude, sass, humor,
yeah.
sarcasm.
Yeah.
Behind it, like there's so much personality in 100%.
And I feel like that always gives it a lightheartedness. Like,
it does.
Even if she's saying something that's like a little heavier, or like, you know, you could rephrase a song like this into being kind of sad. Like,
yeah.
please don't hurt me. Like, I promise I'll leave you, but
that's
like, don't do that to me.
At the moment.
But she's just not
no,
there. Like,
she's
just not like, I'm not gonna cry over a man.
Totally.
Fuck about you. Oh, I don't yeah. give a fuck about you.
That was cool.
You.
No, I'm sorry. That was not obvious. What the fuck was that?
That
was some sort of post-chorus.
Yeah.
And I think that, like, I think about, like, espresso and stuff and, like, parts of the song that make it so listenable and repeatable are those little, like, you know, is it that sweet? I guess so. Like, those little, like, comments that she just kind of says throughout the song or, like,
yeah.
stupid, you know, like, half,
yeah.
half the second verse. Like, she
And you're right, it's
it
always kind of like a post-chorus thing.
Yes.
Like, like you just said,
little...
like, is it that sweet?
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And then it's like, I won't give a fuck about you.
And then
like,
it's almost
that's
like
great.
She's, like, saying... Oh, that was cool, like what we just did, but she
yes.
left it in the song, which is like breaking that kind of fourth wall.
Yeah.
Tell the world you finish your chores prematurely.
Oh, that guitar.
Break my heart and I swear I'm moving on with your favorite athlete. Shoot a shot every night. I want you every second. Don't need other guys. You do something sus, kiss my cute ass.
Oh my god, wait, she said something funny in that verse.
I don't know if you caught the beginning of that verse,
yeah.
but she said, I'll tell the world you finish your chores prematurely. Break my heart and I swear I'm moving on with your favorite athlete.
No, that was funny.
Yeah.
That was funny because like that's kind of linking back to like her saying that she's got so many guys lining up. Like she's got the contacts.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
I will literally move on with someone who you admire and look up to. It is like your hero.
But then she finishes that line with shoot his shot every night. And I feel like that's kind of funny because I'm kind of taking that as like, you know, I can move on with your favorite athlete who shoots his shot every night. Like, you know, another man lining up at my door, but also coming off the back of like, I'll
he
tell the world
actually,
you finish your chores prematurely.
Yeah.
Like, he'll get to like shoot his shot
yes.
every night.
Yeah, that's
yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah,
but
yeah.
But it's like
yeah.
his favorite athlete.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So,
so
that
funny.
Is that's really clever.
I love
clever.
It. I love it.
I won't give a fuck about you. 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 I won't give a fuck about you.
I really loved that.
Oh, there's just something in that production that it's like reminding me of like growing up with like, I don't know, just like,
is it like Destiny Child?
Yeah, it's kind of got this Destiny's Child like J-Lo.
Mm-hmm.
Enrique Iglesias kind of energy.
I know, that was so offensive, the outro, the way her melodies were like following the guitar.
I love it. Yeah, so good. Oh so my god. Good. Really I like that one didn't have a bridge as well. I feel like it really worked for this song because she kind of has that really long post-chorus, like, I don't give a fuck about you. Like, she really did a good job of like filling the song with things outside of having a bridge.
I love that our cups are matching the aesthetic.
Oh, I did that on purpose.
Did you? Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you so much. Sharpest Tool.
Oh, okay.
I feel like this one's going to have like a lot of like cheek and like
I mean, meanings. Yeah, tool. Yeah.
Yeah.
I know you're not the sharpest tool in the shed. We had sex. I met your best friend. Flies by and you forget. I don't hear a word till your guilt creeps in on a Tuesday. Send a soft hey, as if you really don't recall the time we were going right, then you took a left, left me with a lot of shit to second guess. Guess oh, it's another. If that was casual, then I'm an idiot. I'm looking for an answer in between the lines. Lying to yourself if you think we're fine. You're confused and I'm upset, but we never talk about it.
Song.
Yeah, that was not taking an obvious route, especially at the end of that chorus there where the production kind of really picked up. I wasn't expecting that, but it's really pretty. I really like this one. It's like her version of a slower song for this album. I mean, there might be another one coming, but yeah.
And a bit more vulnerable as well. Like, you're kind of talking about how she's joking everything off.
It's not just all lighthearted and upbeat and poppy, but it's still kind of... You know, it's funny because the song's called Sharpest Tool, and she opens the song with, I know you're not the sharpest tool in the shed, which I still feel like is in line with the humorous kind of things, because she's still taking a dig. Like, it's kind of funny that that's what she's saying.
Really love the melody and the way that picked up. I feel like it built the emotion kind of perfectly. And then we're just like, we don't talk about it. Like, you don't get that closure.
Yeah, that was not an obvious way. That melody, how she ends the chorus there, was a bit fucked up. No, you're not the sharpest tool in the shed. We had sex. I met your best friends. Then a bird flies by and you forget. I don't hear a word till your guilt creeps in. On a Tuesday, send a soft hey, as if you really don't recall the time. She's kind of saying, like, this was a big deal for me. Like, we had sex and I met your friends. Like, I thought it was more. But for you, it was just, like, so easy to, like, find someone else or whatever.
Yeah.
Bird flies. It could be, like, you're just so easily distracted by anything. Like, a bird flying by. But bird could be like, a woman. Like, you kind of got, like, a wandering eye.
Yeah. Or,
and I like how this is flowing into the pre-chorus. Because the end of the verse is, on a Tuesday, send a soft hey, as if you really don't recall the time. We were going right, then you took a left, left me with a lot of shit to second guess.
So you think that's like a continued sentence?
Yes. Wait, this is really interesting. Oh my God. Ah, wait, she's doing something here.
Okay.
Every line ends with a word and then she uses that same word to start the next one. So she says, we were going right, then you took a left, left me with a lot of shit to second guess. Guess I'll waste another year on wondering if that was casual, then I'm an idiot.
Oh my God, I love that.
That's so cool.
Amazing. So they turned left, but then he left her.
Yeah.
Love that.
Yeah. I'm looking for an answer in between the lines, lying to yourself if you think we're fine.
Lines.
Ah, yeah, you're right. Stop it. You're confused and I'm upset, but we never talk about it. Oh, and that's the chorus. It's just, we never talk about it. That's the whole chorus.
And sharpest tool because he's just a fucking idiot. Oh my God, I wonder where it's going.
Who wrote this song?
Yeah, actually, I was going to say, we haven't looked at the last two ones. This is Jack.
Jack.
Of course.
Thank you.
Just your strategy, 'cause it leaves you.
us always. Made sure that the phone was face down. Seems like overnight I'm just a bitch you hate now. We never talk it through. How your guilt trip me to open up to you. Then you logged out, leaving me dumbfounded.
That wasn't obvious. What the fuck?
Oh my god, it's saying that that was a fucking bridge in the middle of the song.
Oh my god, it was a bridge and a refrain before going back into the pre-chorus. It wasn't even a second verse.
That was so concerning.
Did you hear how the vocals were like...
Yes, that's distorted.
Yeah.
It was like they were coming in at you.
That was not obvious.
That was fucking Jack Antonoff.
That was fucking Jack Antonoff. All the silence just makes it worse, really, because it leaves you so top of mind for me. You don't fucking talk to me about any of it. It makes me, like, think about you a lot.
I like that there was that distortion on it, though, because it's like the silence is, like, it's, like, how it feels for her. It's, like, kind of just, like, coming in and then leaving her. Yeah. It's, like, this, like...
It's almost a bit, like, dizzying as well.
It felt dizzying.
And then she says, "We never talk about how you found God at your ex's house. Mm. Always made sure that the phone was face down. Mm. Seems like overnight I'm just the bitch you hate now. We never talk it through. How you guilt-tripped me to open up to you. Then you logged out, leaving me dumbfounded."
She, like, mixed it with the chorus because she's like, "We don't talk about..."
That's what she's doing in the refrain. You're right. Yeah. Yes. It's like she's bringing in the "we never talk about it" into that refrain as well.
It's kind of giving Sean, I feel.
Yeah, maybe.
I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. No, you're right.
"If you think we're fine, you're confused and I'm upset, but we never talk about it.
Drum
beat in it. Made sure that the phone was face down. Seems like overnight I'm just a bitch you hate now.
I'm literally obsessed with that melody.
It's so good.
Oh my god.
It's so good. Also, can I say...
No.
I think you might be right about this potentially being a Sean thing, because I looked at what Genius has to say about the "found God at your ex's house", and it's thinking that it's like how men feel like they're having like this fucking divine experience when they orgasm or whatever. So it's like you found God at your ex's house.
Yes. And kind of like taste, because she's talking about going back to the ex. So it's kind of like following the same thing. I also just feel like the way she's like, "You guilted me to open up" and stuff, like, like, he's a very like open, like talkative, emotional boy.
Yeah, he definitely comes across that way.
Yeah,
but you know, male songwriters are hard like that.
They are,
because
they
do kind of give you the impression of being like
emotionally
very
available.
Yeah, like super in tune with how they're feeling, and then they can still be a fucking asshole, you know.
Yeah.
Offensive.
I love it.
Absolutely offensive.
I'm kind of devo that we didn't have this on our trip.
I know, right? In the middle of summer, you're right. Can I just say that Jack Antonoff has supposedly said that this is his favorite off the album?
Okay, that's respectable.
That is respectable.
Like, honestly, that was so fucking good.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And I love the production-wise, it would make a lot of sense to me if that's his favorite, because I think that that was so unique and so different and so creative and beautiful. I loved it.
Oh,
Coincidence is the next track. What is this?
Hey, folky.
"The second I put my head on your chest." She's got a real sick sense. "No name comes up once, then it comes up twice. And without her even being here, she's back in your life. Now she's in the same damn city on the same damn night.
I love it, I love it.
And you lost all your common sense. What a coincidence."
Sorry, there's nothing this woman can't do. This is deeply, deeply superior.
This is. There's something about that, like, guitar thing. It's reminding me of Big Yellow Taxi by Joni Mitchell.
Oh, my God. That is it.
It's got a Joni Mitchell energy to it, this song. Do you know what it's also reminding me of? Canyon Moon.
Oh my God.
Harry Styles.
Yes! Right? It has absolutely the same energy as Canyon Moon.
Yeah! It's got Canyon Moon. It's got Harry Styles, Joni Mitchell energy,
it
this song.
It does, and I love it.
The second I put my head on your chest, she knew she got a real sixth sense. Now her name comes up once, then it comes up twice, and without her even being here, she's back in your life.
Oh my God.
Now she's in the same damn city on the same damn night, and you've lost all your common sense. What a coincidence.
No,
and that was
the
just
ex.
The chorus, those two lines there.
It must be the ex situation again.
Yeah. I really like the way that she's writing this because it's also quite sarcastic, which
it
adds
is.
That humorous element to it too. Like, what she's actually saying is, you've started rekindling things with your ex.
Yeah.
But she's framing it like, oh, wow, what a coincidence.
Yes.
Like, oh, she got this sixth sense and like, oh, she just
she's
happens to be in the same
out.
City again
yeah,
now. And like all
yeah,
these things.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Like, what she's actually saying is, you're fucking playing me.
Totally.
No, the way she sang that was so rude. The way you told me the truth, minus 7%. 7%. I really
she's
like that because she's
on.
Like, yeah, she's, it. It's, now that's really intriguing because mm-hmm. if you watch our videos, you know that we love an add-on chorus.
We do.
But this is different. It's not just like the chorus we've already heard and then a new little bit added mm. on, which is what Taylor Swift loves to do.
Mm.
This is a line in the middle of the two lines mm-hmm. we already had.
Mm.
The way you told me the truth minus 7%.
I love that. It's like you missed a little bit of detail.
Yeah,
what
just
a coincidence.
Just a little bit of detail.
And she's also like whispering it in the background afterwards, which I think adds to that kind of like humor, sassiness, a bit of a secret.
Yep.
It was there in the background.
Yep, totally, totally.
Ooh, I don't know if I'm in my Shawn Mendes era anymore.
What a surprise. Your phone just died. Your car drove itself. That's what you said.
Oh, wow.
What a coincidence.
Oh my God, she's saving!
Oh, wow, you just broke up again.
Oh my fucking God. Oh, wow, you just broke up again.
Coincidence.
Yeah. Yeah. I really loved that energy.
That bridge was really quite superior. I loved the melody of
yeah.
that. What a surprise. Your phone just died. Uh-huh. What a coincidence. Your car drove itself from LA to her thighs.
That is just a lot for her to say.
Damn, it kind of looks like the girl you outgrew. Oh my fucking God. I love how she's kind of then flipping that last meaning to like, oh, when you broke up again, like what a coincidence that it didn't work out.
Yeah.
Like considering
like,
all of this history.
I could have told you
I could have
that
told
that was
you
never
that.
Gonna work. But now you kind of lost both of us. No, that was a great song. I really fucking liked that song. These songs are so good. Hell.
Yeah, that was perfect. 10 out of 10.
This is a very good album so
yeah,
far.
I love every song. Okay. The next track is called Bed Chem?
Probably like Bed Chemistry.
Okay, yes. I was like,
is
I
what
saying?
I'm guessing?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah
bed chem. Okay, cool.
Okay.
What? I was in a sheer dress.
Oh my God. Have you seen like those videos on TikTok and shit that are like, wish that I was like living in my loft in the 80s or whatever, and it's got like this music over the top of it.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's just like, it's just this nostalgia kind of like whatever. And this feels like that. What the
absolutely,
fuck?
I feel like this is giving like sexual healing.
Yes.
Which, you know, if it's bed chemistry, then I guess that's kind of on point.
Yeah.
I was in a sheer dress the day that we met. We were both in a rush. We talked for a sec. You friended me up so we could connect. And what are the odds? You sent me a text and now the next thing I know, I'm like, manifest. That's your oversized. I digress. Got me scrolling like out of breath. Got me going like, who's the cute boy with the white jacket and the thick accent? Maybe it's all in my head, but I bet we'd have really good bed.
God help, she just keeps going and it's too offensive.
Right, this is too sexy.
No, this is the sexiest so thing I've ever heard. Good.
I actually don't know how to handle this.
No, I'm actually ill over the first verse. I loved every lyric. Were you fathoming what the fuck
yes,
she was saying?
Yes, so good.
I was in a sheer dress the day that we met. It had like this flow to it, like she's almost like a little bit rappy. Yeah. I was in a sheer dress the day that we met. We were both in a rush. We talked for a sec. Your friend hit me up so we could connect. And what are the odds? You send me a text. And now the next thing I know, I'm like, manifest that you're oversized. I digress. Got me scrolling like out of breath. Got me going like, who's that cute boy with the white jacket and the thick accent?
Thick accent. No, she was way too cute saying that. This is giving Barry.
Yeah. Thick accent, you know.
Thick accent.
Yeah.
But just also their chemistry is so insane.
Yeah, but I bet we'd have really good bed chem. Mm. How you pick me up, pull them down, turn me round. Mm. Oh, it just makes sense. Mm-hmm. How you talk so sweet when you're doing bad things. That's bed chem. How you're looking at me, yeah, I know what that means, and I'm obsessed. Are you free next week? I bet we'd have really good.
Yeah.
And then she started singing some things.
That was the next verse.
And I was ill. My God. Said. Apparently they met at this Givenchy show in Paris Fashion Week. This is the sheer dress that she's talking about.
Stop it.
No, she's really telling us things.
Really good. Come right on me. I mean camaraderie. Said you're not in my time zone, but you want to be. Where art thou? Why not upon with me? See it in my mind, let's fulfill the prophecy. Who's the cute guy with the wide blue eyes and the big bad night? I know it's not a bit redundant.
No. Those lyrics were too good.
They were
way too
You're
good.
Absolutely kidding.
Come rattle me? I mean camaraderie.
She said, come right on me.
Oh, right on me. I thought you meant right as in like
right. No.
Come right on me.
Yes. 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 Sabrina.
Wait, sorry. Could you say that again?
Okay. Where art thou? Why not uponeth me?
I love that.
See it in my mind. Let's fulfill the prophecy.
So good. I love that she's saying prophecy and like kind of quoting like how Shakespeare would talk as well, because it's like very like linked into that
yeah.
kind of language.
Yeah. Oh my God, this is so good.
And I bet we both arrive at the same time. And I bet the thermostat set at 69. And I bet it's even better than in mine.
So good.
How does
what
she do
fuck?
This? I don't know how she does this. Oh, is it gonna be a fade? I feel like it needs to be. Yes, it's a fade!
Oh my God, she what she just said?
What?
I mean, she literally just said it in the background. She's like, a little fade out.
A little fade out.
No, yes. Wait, I need to go back and hear that again. Oh my god,
that was sexy. I don't know how she does it. I actually don't know how she does it. Her lyrics are so like cheeky, sexy, but never, they're just always perfect. Like I just don't feel like anyone's doing it like her.
Yeah. Everything is so good. Every song is so good.
No, every song is so good.
It's a lot.
Dumb and Poetic.
Ooh.
Is the next song.
Okay.
You're so dumb and poetic. It's just what I fall for. I like the aesthetic. Every self-help book, you've already read it. Cherry pick lines like they're words you invented. Gold star for highbrow. Soft and well spoken, doesn't make you a man.
Sorry, this is about Shawn Mendes.
It's gotta be. It's gotta be. And because, do you know what? I just feel like these lyrics, they kind of give me that exact energy of like male songwriters who think they're like, you know, super emotionally available. Like they know the poetry and the Leonard Cohen lyrics and the whole thing. And they're like the self-help
read
books
every
and
self-help
the whole thing.
Book.
But it's like, you're kind of just a bit of a douchebag.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like
and
getting these like
from that
super wise quotes from a self-help book. And then like, it's like, you're going around making it. It's like, you've had this epiphany. Like you've realized this, but like you got it from a self-help book, bro.
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Wait, can I say that so far the two like slow songs, they kind of start with a similar energy because this is You're So Dumb and Poetic, and then it's like You're Not the Sharpest Tool in the Shed.
So
like
true.
Both of them open with her being like, you're kind of a fucking idiot. Gold Star for Highbrow Manipulation and Love Everyone is your favorite quotation.
So good.
She's got a lot of songs so far on this album where the chorus is just a couple of lines, because this is the same. The chorus is just, don't think you understand, just because you talk like one doesn't make you a man.
Yeah, it's like she's got a very like a lot of like one-liners that hit really hard is the chorus.
Yes.
And I kind of like that because it feels like a lot of the time like the pre-chorus or the verse is like kind of a bit of a like flow.
Yeah, they're flowing into one another
and
really
then it's
nicely.
Like it hits with this like she kind of like ends you with the chorus.
Yeah.
Or ends the man that she's singing about.
Yeah. Yeah.
With the chorus, which I kind of like. It's a real like point.
Mm-hmm. Dumb and Poetic. I love that too, because even just like the name of the song implies that like this person like has these one-liners or maybe you can write songs.
Yes.
It's like you're poetic, you're good at that.
Yeah, you are.
But you're also fucking dumb.
So true.
You're running so fast from the hearts that you're breaking. Save all your breath for your four meditation.
Yeah.
You're so empathetic, you'd make a great wife. And I promise the mushrooms aren't changing your life. Will you crash the car and abandon the wreckage? Fuck with my head like it's some kind of fetish. Don't think you understand.
Oh my gosh, she's ripping into this man. You know what's so fucking funny about these lyrics is that if they are about Shawn Mendes, it's fully fitting this fucking folklore era he's
yes,
in.
Yes, it is. Oh my god, I think she just like ruined his folklore era.
I think she did because he's all like,
he's like
nature and like I'm having all these fucking epiphanies, like all this bullshit. Like you're in this like fucking hippie vibe right now.
Oh my gosh, she's really
the floor meditation, and I promise the mushrooms aren't changing your life. Help, you're so empathetic. You'd make a great wife.
No,
I
that
can't.
Was too much.
It's just so funny. What the fuck?
And it's that first line was also kind of linking back to the other song where she's like, we don't talk about it. And then here,
yes,
there's no communication.
But baby, you put us in this situation.
Yeah.
I thought the same thing. Yeah. Like that, because that's like an entire song about the fact that he's not talking
so
to
true.
Her about
so
anything
true.
That's happening.
Anyway, we have like one line. But I would love to see how this ends.
Just cause you leave like one,
oh, leave like
doesn't
one.
Make you a man.
Holy fucking shit. Just cause
it's
you
giving
leave
leaving like,
one, like
a father,
running
like
water.
It's giving folklore.
It is the actual folklore.
The actual
the good
folklore. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Yes.
It's also kind of giving emails I can't send, like her. Her relationship with her dad,
yes,
kind of thing. Like that's
yes.
how she has seen men behave. So that is actually like a man.
Absolutely. Yeah. You leave like a man because so many men do, unfortunately. Really perfect placement on the track list. Especially when you take into consideration that the last song before this would have been Espresso. Yeah, it's like we've had a really good run of like mostly upbeat songs. I think that Sharpest Tool was a good little break without fully taking us out of that like beat kind of poppy energy. But it was necessary at this point.
Really,
I think if we got another like high upbeat song, I'd be like, no, I actually do think I need a break.
Yeah.
So she
that
she's
was perfect.
Ordered this really, really well.
Now we're up to Slim Pickins.
Slim Pickins. Cool.
So that's like could be playing on like the fact that there's like not a lot of good options out there in the dating world, maybe. Slim Pickins. You
know?
Yeah. Oh. Oh. Oh, pretty.
life alone. I am not dramatic, these are just the thoughts that pass right through me. All the douchebags in my phone.
Such a rude melody.
Play them like a slot machine. If they're winning, I'm just losing. A boy who's jacked and kind can't find his ass to save my life. Oh, it's Slim Pickens. If I can't have the one I love, I guess it's you that I'll be kissing. Just to get my fixings. Since the good ones are deceased or taken, I'll just keep on moaning and bitching.
Moaning and bitching. So, so pretty. No, the prettiest that's ever been, as pretty as it could possibly be.
Truly. And still so silly. She's still being so silly in these lyrics.
So cheeky. You know those first lyrics?
Guess I'll end this life alone. I am not dramatic. These are just the thoughts that pass right through me.
No, I love that. Relatable content.
All the douchebags in my phone play them like a slot machine. If they're winning, I'm just losing.
No, I love that. I love that. It's a perfect gambling metaphor, especially like the slot machines, poker machines. Like they just keep winning if
and
you're losing.
Yep. Oh, it's Slim Pickings. If I can't have the one I love, I guess it's you that I'll be kissing just to get my fixings. Since the good ones are deceased or taken, I'll just keep on
deceased
moaning and bitching.
Or taken. Oh my God, it's Slim Pickings out there.
Slim Pickings, absolutely.
No, this is relatable content.
Here, it is.
Jesus, what's a girl to do? This boy doesn't even know the difference between there and they are. He's naked in my room, missing all the things he's missing. God knows that he isn't living large. A boy who's nice that breathes, I swear he's no.
A boy that's nice and who breathes is what she just said. Sorry, a boy who's nice that breathes.
It's hard to
I mind. Swear he's nowhere to be seen. Like, literally just one that's alive and nice, please. Like, oh, I love this, like, country vibe. It's got a little country essence to it.
It does.
Oh my God! No, the music is so
since
pretty.
The good ones call their exes wasted. And since the Lord forgot my gay awakening, then I'll just be here in the kitchen, serving up some moaning and bitching.
What? Those lyrics were so funny.
So funny.
Oh my God.
What did she say?
She said, since the good ones call their exes wasted.
Uh-huh. Okay. Yep. Yeah.
And since the Lord forgot my gay awakening. Literally, it would be easier if I liked women.
Yeah, I just am straight, unfortunately.
Then I'll just be here in the kitchen serving up some moaning and bitching. That is fucking hilarious.
That's hilarious.
My God. That was a Jack song.
I was going to say, is that Jack?
That was a Jack song.
So, okay. It's not as heavy on Jack as I thought this album would be.
Yeah.
So far, anyway.
Yeah. There's a few in there, though, which is nice.
Yeah.
There's a few in there.
Juno. I'm intrigued.
Your dad's genetics.
Oh, I love this melody.
You make me wanna make you fall in love. Oh, late at night I'm thinking about you. I wanna try on my fuzzy pink handcuffs. Oh, I hear you knocking, baby. Come on up. I know you want my
this song?
What is this pop perfection goddess material right here?
Oh my god, I think she's referencing Juno the movie.
You know, that was my first thought.
Oh my god, I fucking love that movie.
It's such a good movie. Is she saying like, I'll let you Juno me as in like get me pregnant?
Yes! Yeah. Are you kidding? This is so good. This song that movie is so
giving
good.
Impregnate me. This song is absolutely giving ovulation.
Don't have to tell your hot ass a thing. Oh yeah, you just get it.
Mm-hmm.
Whole package, babe. I like the way you fit. God bless your dad's genetics. You make
I wonder if this is about Barry.
You make me want to make you fall in love. Oh, late at night, I'm thinking about you. Mm. Want to try out my fuzzy pink handcuffs. Mm-hmm. Oh, I hear you knocking. Mm. Baby, come on up. And then in the chorus, she says...
It was all a little like, ow! And like, yeah! The way she was like doing things that was so superior.
No, so good. I know you want my touch for life. If you love me right, then who knows? I might let you make me Juno.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's saying like, I might let you impregnate me. Yeah. You know I just might let you lock me down tonight. One of me is cute, but two though, give it to me, baby.
Oh my God,
you make
two,
me wanna make you
like,
fall in love. You're like her and her little baby. No, stop it. What the fuck is this song? Are you kidding me? This, nobody's ever written a song like this before.
No, but it also sounds like this magical Barbie land song or something. Like
it does.
The chorus had this like feeling that was just so feminine and beautiful and pretty and magical and fairy tale like and like so sweet.
Yeah.
So sweet.
Yeah. Sweet. Yes.
I feel like it's giving me Kylie Minogue.
Yeah, I get that.
And everything went from wrong to right.
Yeah, you're so right. It's got Kylie vibes.
At first sight. Cute, but too
low. Give it to me, baby. I can't. What? This song is so good.
This post-hold me, hold me and explore me. Mark your territory. You make me wanna fall in that.
No, 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 no.
Oh my God, I think that might be my favorite.
That was so good. That you're absolutely perfect. Kidding. That was Nobody's ever written a song like that before. Nobody has ever written that song before.
No. I love like, two though, give it to me. Or something like, she's like,
yes,
she's like,
she does say that.
The two, give it to me.
Yeah, she does. That's exactly what she says. Yeah, yeah.
Oh my God, it's perfect. The most superior, iconic Sabrina Carpenter song I've ever heard in my entire existence. That was something else.
I can't believe that this was just hiding towards the end of this album.
How dare she? You know, it's kind of like giving like, where she put like Bad for Business, because we had such a reaction to that song.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Oh, that's a good fucking song.
Good song, good song.
That is a good fucking song.
But it's kind of like a similar placement, I feel.
Yeah, you're right.
I don't know how to move on.
No, I know, but we've still got three songs. How does one go on?
We have
truly?
Two songs.
Oh, we have two songs. Sorry, we've only got two songs.
We've only got two songs. So the second last song is called Lie to Girls.
Okay.
Don't swear on your mom that
but it's the first drink that you've had in like a month.
This is Jack.
And don't say it was just an isolated incident that happened once. There's no need to pretend. I've never seen an ugly truth that I can't bend to something that looks better. I'm stupid, but I'm clever. Yeah, I can make a shit show look a whole lot like forever.
Oh,
and ever. You don't have to lie to girls. If they like you, they'll just lie to themselves. Like you, they'll just lie to themselves.
This song is mean.
All your best excuses. No, they don't stand a chance against.
Oh my God. Deeply, Sabrina. Did you hear what she just said in that chorus? That affected me deeply to the soul. You don't have to lie to girls, they just lie to themselves. Sabrina Carpenter. This is how girlies feel.
It's true. It's true.
No, I'm not okay. That was way.
And it's kind of. Do you know what? It's actually perfect because it's kind of got that mellow kind of vibe again to it. Because it's kind of sad.
It is sad.
It's kind of sad. They're just lying to themselves.
She's almost like. She's not like feeling sorry for herself particularly. She's like kind of attacking men as a whole because of like what women do for men and how we like make them look better than they actually are.
And also that this can only be a pattern of girls if men are consistently shit.
Yes.
So it's like calling out the fact that men are constantly
but we kind
doing
of put
stuff
up with it.
That women, yeah, are putting up with or making excuses for.
Yeah, yeah.
No.
Oh my God, it's so sad.
It's so sad.
It's sadder because of that collective experience, I think I feel.
Yeah,
like,
totally.
It's not just her experience. Like, she's talking on behalf of women here and it's like that girlhood and it just
which is
really
why
hurts.
The way that the chorus is worded specifically is so clever. Because she could just say, you don't need to lie to me, I'll lie to myself. But she's making it this like, no, this is something that is so common amongst women.
Yeah, that's really, really smart, actually.
Yeah. Don't swear on your mum that it's the first drink that you've had in like a month. No, don't say it was just an isolated incident that happened once. Mm. There's no need to pretend. I've never seen an ugly truth that I can't bend to something that looks better. I'm stupid, but I'm clever. Yeah, I can make a shit show look a whole lot like forever and ever.
That was fucked.
I can make a shit show look a whole lot like forever and ever.
Because the lies that we tell ourselves.
Yeah. I've never seen an ugly truth that I can't bend to something that looks better.
No.
Stop it.
No, superior lyrics.
Stop it. Oh, you don't have to lie to girls. If they like you, they'll just lie to themselves. Don't I know it better than anyone else is how she ends that chorus.
Oh my God, another short and like pretty precise chorus.
Oh, well, sorry. Yeah, she does repeat that, the you don't have to lie to girls thing, but it's just sort of all the same lyrics.
It's still kind of like a very...
It's a to-the-point chorus.
To the point, one-liner chorus.
Yeah.
That does wrap up the whole concept of the song really well.
Oh my God, the beat that came in.
Yeah.
All of your best excuses. No, they don't stand a chance against all the chances I give you. Isn't ideal, but damn, you don't even have to try. Turn you into a good guy. You don't have to lift a finger. It's lucky for you, I'm just like my mother and my sister. All my friends. The girl outside the strip club getting her tarot cards read.
We love to read the cold hard facts and sweater and correct.
We love to mistake butterflies for cardiac arrest. You don't.
What? Oh my God.
She just said, I love to mistake butterflies
for cardiac arrest.
No. I feel like the girls have had a fathoming over the last few years that like butterflies aren't necessarily a good sign and a good feeling because it's actually more of a sign of stress, and she's literally comparing it to a cardiac arrest. That is genius.
Also, we love to read the cold hard facts and swear they're incorrect.
Yes. Yeah.
But I love that that earlier lyric as well where she was like tying in all those women. She's like,
No, that hurt me.
It's lucky for you, I'm just like my mother and my sisters, all my friends. Mm-hmm. The girl outside the strip club getting her tarot cards read. No. All your best excuses, they don't stand a chance against all the chances I give you. Mm. Isn't ideal, but damn, you don't even have to try. Turn you into a good guy. You don't have to lift a finger.
Yeah, like I do all the work.
Yeah.
Giving, I can fix him. No, really, I can.
Yeah, truly. Do you know what? That's really funny that you say that, because I was literally just thinking, I feel like this is kind of what tortured poets is. Mm. It's like, there was a guy who really was displaying some interesting qualities, mm-hmm. and it's like, I just kind of lied to myself to convince myself that you would be my forever because of how you made me feel. Mm-hmm. I was lying to myself, but like, maybe... Mm. Those signs were always there, you know?
So true, so true. Oh my God. Yeah. I love the production. Girls were crying, girls were lying, girls will do it till they die for you. They're crying, girls were lying, do it till the day they die for you.
For us to process, I think it might
I think
be.
It is.
Yeah.
Oh, just coming through with that.
No,
guitar.
The noises. No, the sounds in that outro. Holy shit.
Oh my God, I really felt that one. And I think it was because of the production. Like, the melody and everything was so beautiful, but the production was very unexpected, and it built this like anxiety towards the song, and the way that that bridge just kept like repeating and like a wave of emotion came over, and then oh my God, Jack Antonoff, I love him.
Oh my God, that was a Jack song. You said that, didn't you? No. Jack fucking Antonoff.
I'm gonna need time with that one because that offended me, that hurt my feelings, that left me in a bit of a state, and holy shit, my favorite production on the whole album.
Yeah, that I completely understand. That was a fucked up song. We've only got one song left.
Oh my God, this album's so good. I'm concerned.
It's so good.
I'm actually not gonna be able to listen to anything else. The last track, Don't Smile.
Don't Smile, okay. My last track, oh.
Oh, nice. I love that energy. Oh, so dreamy.
It is.
This is nice.
Don't smile because it happened, baby. Cry because it's over.
It's like the opposite.
Yeah. It's really quite perfect. Like, it's not as upbeat as a lot of the songs, but it's also, this is so unique. This is so unique.
It is. It's interesting because, like, the rest of the album has been so, like, I guess, in her power, kind of, like, definitely not letting this breakup or this relationship get her down for the most part.
Yeah.
And then this last song is, like, she's flipped that common saying, which is like, don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. Like, be grateful that you had something special. Mm-hmm. And she's kind of like, nah, fuck that. Like, I'm going to fucking can cry because it's over. But the song is so soothing.
So she started with the chorus, obviously, which I really like. That's the first time on this album I think she's done that.
Except for Espresso.
Yes. Smile because it happened, baby. Cry because it's over.
And then, like, oh, you're supposed to think about me every time you hold her. Like, and I think that that really fits with, like, a lot of the themes on this album about, like, him getting back together with his ex.
True.
Like,
yeah.
Think about me. Taste me.
Yeah. Like, true. True. You're right.
It kind of links back nicely to Taste, actually.
Yeah, you're
which
right.
Which is the opening True. Song. No. I'm
every single song is so obsessed. Good. Every single song is so good.
So good. I do love it. I wish you could end this album.
I know.
Pour my feelings in the microphone. I stay in them when the girls come home. I want one of them to take my phone. Take my phone and lose your number. I don't want to be tempted. Pick up when you want to fall back.
Production.
Yes,
like Mirage era Fleetwood
so
Mac.
So true, you're right. And I think like ending it like that with a fade as well, like it definitely feels kind of comforting, even though like we're ending on a bit of a sad note, or like I don't know, she's like kind of saying like it's over, right? Like the album's over. Don't smile, cry because it's over. So like there's definitely like an ending there, like a bit of closure in a way, like. But it's also still a little bit sad.
Do you know what? I feel like there's something about this track list setup that makes me feel like she's even thought about what it would be like to listen to it on repeat. Because I feel like Lie to Girls and Don't Smile are just mellow enough that then to go back to listening to Taste right at the end of this, perfect. You're ready for that energy again.
So true.
Because she's ended it not with this super upbeat poppy kind of vibe. Yeah, I don't know. Right. I just think it, like, literally the order of this track list is perfect. Perfect.
Yeah.
I'm actually... Do you know what? I knew that we would love this album, but I'm actually quite shocked.
I think it's better than
shocked
I even expected.
That there is not one song on here that I am like, I could leave that.
Yeah.
Because there was, you know, there was a couple of songs on Emails I Can't Send that I was like, yeah, you know, not my favorite, like whatever.
Yeah.
Even though the overall album is really, really great. But this
is like perfect.
Every single song is so good.
Yeah, I agree. I actually just don't even know how to pick my favorite. Like Juno,
yeah,
was superior.
Juno
Slim Pickings,
so, no, I
so
actually
fucking
don't.
Concerning.
No.
Good Graces, Taste.
Do you think that I can?
Coincidence was so good as well.
No.
Lie to Girls is hurtful.
I think you just said the entire album. This album is so good. It's so good.
Guys, I'm gonna need some time to recover. This is so superior and offensive. Don't forget to head over to our Patreon and check out our reaction to the two bonus tracks. We're gonna listen to them in a minute. Sabrina Carpenter, the
what
woman
you
that
done?
You are, we love you. We are so happy that you're having your moment.
Absolutely.
So well deserved. And this album is 10 out of 10. And I'm just going to live by it for the next few
months. Yeah. No, it's a perfect album. What can I say? There really is nothing more to add.
No, there's
truly
not.
Perfect album. Oh my God. Guys, we also love you. We're so happy that we're back.
So happy to be back, guys.
And we will see you soon for another video.
We sure will.
Bye. Bye.